drip, drip. I just bought Nexus 3 and I want to show you guys what it can do. So today in this live stream, if you're watching the replay before everybody else gets here, I'm going to go through Nexus 3. We're going to make a couple tracks in the style of Lil Durk. I want to do one in the style of NBA Youngboy and, you know, go over a couple ideas. So let me wait for our folks to join us. So again, if you're watching the replay, feel free to skip a little bit ahead to get straight to Nexus 3. I'm just going to say my hellos for everybody who is joining us live. So let me make sure we're all good. YouTube says we're live. Sometimes it takes a little bit to ding everybody. Hamza is in the building. Escobar, what's going on? 17's Danny. 17Z Danny. Ethan, what's up, Ethan? I remember your username, even though it's so basic. Deshaun Johnson, what's up? Knight Rider. There we go. Leah Brown is back. What's up? Irfan Deacon. What's up, Mood? Hashtag Mood, right? AR Beat. So today I'm going to go through Nexus 3 just real quick as a recap of what I just said, I guess, before we were live or online, fully online. Is today I'm going to go through Nexus 3. We're just going to use it in actuality, not just like going through a bunch of features, but actually using it as if you were making a beat. And I want to do something in the style of Lil Durk and NBA Youngboy today. So like piano based for NBA Youngboy, and for Lil Durk more trap, like hardcore drill trap. ARB, so let me see. Sahil's here, Venus is here, Formonic, what's up? Austin's not dead, what's up? When did Nexus 3 come out? It came out on Black Friday. So here's, I forgot I turned on slow-mo, my fault. Let me turn that off. My bad. It's because we had spammers yesterday. So let me turn that off. Forgot to turn that off. So sorry about the slow mode. That's my bad. Let me say my hellos real quick. Grand Unchallenged. Hassan is here. What's up, KJ Beats? Low Key Music. What's up? Courtney Martis. Manib is here. What does it say? Nikhil Nervin. Probably saying that wrong. Innocent Selly. What up, Johnny X Beats? My voice is a little... I gotta be a little tame today because doing lives for so long really gets to your voice. TJ, I see AG, the OG at the bottom there. Pifia, it's from Chile. There you go. DJ Mike C, what's up? Brian, I think I answered your question. It came out Black Friday. Jess the Slap, what's up? Jorge, what's up? I'm pretty good. Greetings from Mexico. There we go. Some out of towners in the building. Young Boy Paradise, Felix, Detroit Hero, what's up? Polano, what's up? Commodity Beats, Felix, I said Felix. Automatic, what's up? Buffo on the beat is here. RNS Productions, Damien's here. And who else is new? YNG, Deepak, and Jayant. I'm trying to finish the list. And Mike Dallas and 16. Finally, you finished the list before it got too overwhelming. What is it? Game, are you already entered? Yes. So if you've already entered the free giveaway, we're giving away Nexus 3 this Friday. So enter to win. What's up, T-Rex? Enter to win with that link right there, or just go to the video description. So with all my hellos out the way and without slow mode on, we can get back to the actual getting to itness. So today, again, the focus is going to be just showing you how Nexus sounds just with the default factory sounds without any expansion packs. And I want to create a Lil Durk track and an NBA Youngboy track today. So let's start with Lil Durk just to get our beat making skills warmed up. An easy trap beat. Show you how to flip these sounds into trap. And then we'll get into the NBA Youngboy, more melodic piano type of stuff. Okay, let's get into some trap. So let's go to factory presets. Now for trap, you want to go for more bells type of sounds and more plucky sounds, very short sounds. Sometimes we use pads, but rarely. If you're going for that Playboi Carti, I don't know why I said it that way, Playboi Carti style, then you're going to go for more of a pad. We don't really use soft sounds. So I'm doing pretty good. So my voice, I'm just trying to not scream into the mic because 8 hours of streaming every day kind of takes a toll. Anyway, so, or guitar, that's another instrument. So the categories you're going to look for trap, let me just say this again to make it easy. You're going to look at the bells. They don't have a bells category, which I'm actually surprised they don't have any bells. A plucked category and guitar category and piano as a go-to. But for trap, you're going to stick with those three: bells, guitars, or plucked. Okay. So let's go to plucked. I'm assuming their bells are in here. And let's put their search to test. Let's type in bell, B-E-L-L. Not too many bells. I'm actually surprised how little bells they have in the factory library. Because bells are huge in trap, so not sure why. Yeah, that kind of threw me off a little bit, but maybe they figured their bells, you only need but so many, I don't know. So the question is, what style of bell? So let me go through these bells, see which one. So for trap, it's up to you how you want to go about it, but let's do like a little dirt kind of Chicago style drill. So we don't want those like heart, we don't want anything that sounds romantic, basically. There we go, the beautiful life we have. So we need something a little bit harder like this. A little more edgy. All I'm going to do here is take off delay so we have more control about the bounce. You recommend trap, do you recommend for trap Nexus? If not, which VSTs? We'll see today. I haven't really gone through the sounds enough. Trap is more about the effects you put on the sound. It's really not even about the sound, but you need a decent source sound. Okay, so I had to draw out the melody because my brain. So in this live, I won't like go too deep about everything, because that tends to throw off the beat making process for me. But let's hear the melody. Okay, so we want this to sound more dark and like it's from Chicago. You got to think they have murders all the time in Chicago. How do we make this sound dark? So one way we could do this is using a low pass filter to cut out some of the brightness. So darkness is talking about frequency contents. Dark usually means lower frequency content. Bright usually means higher frequency content. And it's more lenient towards one side or the other. So let's cut out the high frequency content. And that's going to instantly give us a quote unquote dark sound. Now to kind of beef it up a bit, let's use some resonance. It's going to create like this hollowed sound. Okay, now let's give it a little bit more of an edge. Let's see what effects they have. Let's start with their effects and then let's work in our effects. Let's see what we get with the arpeggio. Let's just turn it on just to see. And let's do 160. I don't hear the notes changing, so. Oh, you know why? It's because our filter's on, go. So if you do want an edgier sound in this case, I would use the octaves because it shortens out the note, which makes them tighter. So hardness is about the downbeat and very short notes. Okay, so that's what creates the idea of hardness. Now, one thing I want to try here is I hope this is a universal. Let me see if I can do this with something up here. So what I'm going to do is gate, so make these arpeggio notes shorter. And I think the tail that's created is the reverb. You know what? Let's turn the length. Wait, no, it's not the length. Usually gate cuts the notes short. This doesn't seem to do anything. I guess it does a little bit. So I'm getting into a lot of sound design stuff, but basically if you pull down the release. Okay, so now it's very like choppy and stuttery sounding. And that's the sound we want to sound hard. Oh, there we go. 17 Danny says, 17's Danny said, you taught me tips, not even just about music, but in life, just general stuff. Sold my first beat pack yesterday too. There we go. It's all about confidence. There you go. Now you have the confidence to keep moving that momentum forward. And I guarantee you, you'll start seeing bigger and better results. So it's all about, once you realize you have value to offer, it's about going harder after that point. How much is Nexus? Nexus, I think, is 200 if you're new. I bought it as an upgrade, so it was 100. And if you bought it within the last, like October or whatever, I think you get Nexus 3 for free. But let's work with this. Make these notes a little bit shorter. And here's what I'm going to do to give it its low vibe. I'm just going to pull the filter down. This is more advanced. And pull the decay curvature on the filter envelope. Now, for some reason, this works backwards, I think. Since it's kind of convoluted to even hear, I'm just going to disregard that, actually. But now you see we have an edge. So let's go to the effects and let's add some distortion in here. So what I didn't know is you have a drop down under these inserts. You can change the effect. And distortion creates upper harmonics, which is also a feature of hard music. But the thing is, this is too aggressive. So let's pull it back. And you could change the drive level, which is like how hard is being pushed. I only want like a subtle. Okay, so we went from a pretty basic bell sound. Here's the original sound. Just so we can compare. Let's compare these side by side. Let's paste this in. Control C, Control V. And let's move these notes to the right, just so you can hear the comparison. So the first one is our sound. The second one is the default. Or sorry. Did I clone it? I sure didn't clone it. I almost did that without cloning it. So we went to Plux. What was it? Forgot the preset name. The preset is called FM Bells. So let's pull that up real quick. Factory plucked FM Bells. So here's the default patch to the right. Here's ours. Here's theirs. What's up, Tryler? So, I mean, it depends on like the style of song you're going for too. There's no right or wrong, but just showing you how far we've taken the sound. November is over for you. You got Omnisphere too. Yeah, we're going to get into some music theory using Nexus just to show you how to do it. So right here, if you look at the structure, it's really ACE. This is really A minor, and we're just starting on the fifth. So it's the fifth root note, third, fifth. We're breaking apart a chord. And the more you think about your melodies like chords and breaking them apart, you'll have a lot of an easier time. Let's pull this down an octave. It's funny. How do you say your name? Kanto? Kinto? Your old banks. I'm assuming you mean the old expansions. Yeah, they load. Everything's cross-gradle. I don't even know the terms. Everything's backwards compatible. I don't know if you use user presets. I don't know how that works, but I do know the expansions load up fine. And you have an updater thing. It's called like the REFX Cloud, and they update all your stuff for you anyway. So it's very easy to install. It's not difficult. All right, so let's get to the trap. So again, we're making a little Dirk, so we got to make this scary. So let's go. I'm going to show you all the little nuances I'll do. So let's go to the modulation tab. Let's add vibrato. Actually, let's do an LFO. We have to go to the mod matrix, go to LFO 1, and let's have that control the pitch. So let's figure out where the pitch even is. Oscillator 1. This is a little bit difficult. Let me see. What would pitch be under? I guess miscellaneous pitch. Okay. I'm wondering why that's under miscellaneous. But. And then you would set LFO1 to control this. So here's LFO1 right here. Let's just set it to free mode. Let's set it to a sine wave and change the speed. And just pull down your speed. And let's pull back the range a little bit. This really isn't, it's kind of like vague what's what. It doesn't really tell you what's happening. But just pull in your range a little bit. Basically, it's the wobble effect. Halftime. Yeah, I'm going to get into some techniques here. I just want to show what the plugin can do first before we get into all the third-party stuff. Thank you, Jorge. I appreciate you. Jaden Smith stuff's pretty in depth. A lot of analog sound in there too. All right, so let me get back to the effects. So let's add some reverb, but then add a pre-delay to the reverb and then give it a short decay. So it's really like a throw delay. It's not like a long reverb. Now let's hit shift down to switch the key. And I'm just going to pull this note down one. All Now, I feel like the arpeggio is going a little too fast, so let's pull it back. Also, with trap, you want to change the way your arpeggio goes. Let's change it to a down. Even though it's not moving fast enough for you to hear it, so let's make it fast. It's kind of odd how it sounds like it's going up, even though I have it on down mode, which is confusing. Let's make this faster. I just want to hear if it's going down. That's a little weird. Let me see something. Let's take off these gates. It's going up, not down. What, no easy? This is weird. This is broken, I think. Yeah, this is supposed to go downward. It's going up. That's weird. Unless I might be... Maybe play a chord. You have to play multiple notes at a time, that's why. A little weird. Usually when you go down octaves, the octaves will go down, but I guess there's no other note to go down to. A little weird of a philosophy on that, but whatever. It wasn't even like a timing thing. It was just like trying to figure out the ARP style. Okay, I'm talking too much about the ARP, so let's move into applying this sound. Now, a lot of people think it's about the sound in itself. With trap music, it's about everything else that you do to it. So it's more of a post-production sound. Trap is a post-production thing. Let's run it through halftime. Now, this may get chaotic because we already have three octaves of movement. It's a cool bounce, so let's just pull it back. I feel like we lost the kind of the sound. Oh, you know, we're on the wrong patch. How did we get here? How did that happen? Or maybe I just made it sound like a bell. I don't know. It just sounded different. Let's take off the ARP. Let's actually go back to the factory sound. And here's where you can take your melody to the next level. Start harmonizing so that have two notes play at the same time. Not a chord, but two notes. Great option when it comes to trap. I'd never heard of Euphoria before. Sorry, I'm missing a lot of questions. But we're going over Nexus 3, just seeing how it sounds in context. We're going to make a trap track for Lil Durk right now, which is a Chicago drill sound. I've been trying to create trap beats like Jaden, but Jaden uses a lot of real instruments. That's probably the reason you're not getting his sound, because he's using $2,000 synthesizers, guitars with crazy pedals on it, stuff that you just can't get in your DAW. Let's add a couple notes in here. Okay, so this is how you beef up your melodies. Just use two notes at a time that sound good together. There's no specific one, but you want to look at your perfect fourths and your perfect fifths. So this right here looks like a fourth. One, two, three, four, five. Semitones away. And this looks like a fifth. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And that's why they work, because they always sound good together. And this is an octave. Octaves also sound good together. Now, this was without any effects. So that's one reason your melodies sound kind of different. Just try harmonies, stacking. Did you buy their starter? The starter. I just have the one for... I have expansion packs from Nexus 2. I didn't buy any expansions. I just upgraded. It was $99 to upgrade. But I would go with the starter first and then figure out which expansions you like the best. I don't know how the other packages work. Maybe you're allowed to choose. I'm not sure. Keyscape, I only use like two of the pianos, so it kind of, I mean, unless I'm going for a grand piano sound or Rhodes sound, I don't really use Keyscape like that. Not sure who produced for Jaden. Sure he is the top, the best of the best, because who doesn't love Will Smith? Okay, so now let's start adding effects. Now here's where you go crazy with the grow speed, the reverse effects, back mask even. Where's the back mask? And you start reversing stuff. I don't know how to use back mask because they label everything with weird stuff. So I wish there was a mix level. I'm just going to use the mix level here. Just a little too much reverse. So what I'm going to do is create an automation clip that slowly brings in back mask over time, because I feel like that reverse gets too in the forefront. So you want to look at automation also for halftime as well. A lot of people don't think to automate the thing that makes their melody sound trappy. So try automating. Even you can even automate the fruity delay pitch wobble effect that I show you all the time. I might even take it out every other just so it doesn't get overwhelming. So back mask and halftime really fix the problem that grow speed has, which is a timing issue. So back mask fixes the timing of the reverse, and halftime fixes the timing of the halftime effect in grow speed. Because grow speed, if you play your beat like from a random spot in the beat, it'll play off beat, and that's one of the issues a lot of people have. Let's swap out the sound. I'm gonna add all these effects and then start swapping out the sound later. It's almost like effects on your vocals. What size is my monitor? Not huge. It's a 17-inch laptop screen. Back mask is not free. No, I don't think it is. It's not super extremely expensive either. Anyone use? Nah. A-Rap music? I would need like an MPC. I don't think a lot of people ask for that though. Really, he just plays it out on the MPC. I mean, I don't know if you could do all this. You could do the same stuff in FL, but it would be very, unless you play everything by hand. So let's add these effects real quick. Let me show you the FL Studio Delay 3 trick. Pull down your dry level, pull down your feedback, and pull down your delay time and turn up time modulation. Now here's the key. You can either mess with the time modulation, which let's try. Let's right click, create an automation clip. Or you can also right click the mix level, create an automation clip. And this will have it will make it feel more random, like actual tape pitch wobble being random versus just predictable. So let's create these random nodes here. And if you want to make it even more random, give me a sec. I don't like FL's new thing. But anyway, you right click and change it to something like smooth stairs. If you zoom in, it will change this line structure. So that doesn't help. That was kind of basic. Let's do stairs. And you can left click. Got to kind of finesse it. But if you look closely, whoops, give me a sec. I keep clicking the wrong button. So if you look closely, it'll create this like shape within a shape. And you could do any type of effect you want. You could do half sine wave. I don't know what that is. Kind of curved on one side. Let's do a pulse. Just kind of change it up. See what the sounds like. Okay, and create your own like stutter effects. And this is really unique because nobody has this. This is not a plugin. I don't know about the wave one. It's a little chaotic. Let's try mix using your automation clip. And then go through the automation time and just kind of move it over time. I would change it back to smooth to keep it basic. Single curve, not smooth. And just kind of move it around. I don't like the square one because it's too obvious. So let's take that to a different. And this is just one plugin that's free in FL. People just don't know how to maximize it. And now it sounds like a bunch of things going on. Oh, I didn't know. Backmaster's weird. It just doesn't, their company doesn't label anything. So it's just like, you got to turn knobs to figure out what does what. So it kind of, it's cool, but in the same way, it's kind of like a turnoff. So now let's go back to the, oh, what's going on, official lost cause? Let's go back to the sound source. And again, we're looking for bell sound. So what I did was I typed in bell. They have a new search function in Nexus. Only issue right now is that it doesn't hold your search value. So once you click out this menu, it'll reset and you have to research for it. I don't know if they did that on purpose or what. But for me, if I'm searching for something and I click out, I want to go back to what I was searching. And there's no history of like what you were searching, at least from what I can see. What's up, Ascending Keys? So shout out to everybody in here. How many folks we got in here? I'm just curious because I randomly stream. I don't even know. We got a good strong 200 folks in the room. So that's pretty cool. So let me know. Oh, here, before I forget to tell you, you can enter to win Nexus 3 for free. All right. So just click that link or go to busyworksbeats.com/giveaway. I'm giving away Nexus 3 this Friday. My bad. Hood known. Let me see. What's up? Hood known. Oh, what's up? So I don't read every single comment. Be fair with you there. I try and skim it, but I don't want to get caught up in the Q&A session just yet. So let's swap out the sounds and just see what sounds cool. I think this sounds more creepy in a good way. Let's turn up the reverb. They have new reverbs. I don't know what nuclear means, but let's see. Oh, okay. That didn't work. So we found out how to break Nexus 3. It looks like FL just completely froze when we changed the reverb. All right, so Nexus 3 clearly has bugs. Darn, I don't know if I saved the project though. Sheesh. All right, here's what I gotta do. I gotta X out of FL. I'm sure we've seen this before. I'm sure you're familiar with. All right, we should be good. My bad. Sorry for the interruption. That was completely... Oh, man. I didn't save. That sucks. But luckily, the melody wasn't that complicated. So we figure out how to break Nexus 3. That's for sure. Another way to break Nexus 3 is if you go to, I think it was the trance gate, and you click up here somewhere, it just breaks. So, I mean, I'm not going to... You know, they're trying to figure stuff out. I don't know where the backup is. Where's the backup? Current project, recent files, which one? Regardless, I think starting from scratch would be cool because we already know how to make trap beats. Let's just be straight. Like, we made trap beats 1,000 times over and 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 over. So I think you know how to make trap beats. You learned what you learned. Just rewind the video if you want to learn some more trap techniques. It's all about your melody though and making your melody sound unique. So hopefully you took away the melody concepts. We did that. The drums are like basic trap drums. I mean, what else? I mean, we did trap 1,000 times. Let's do the NBA YoungBoy style. So now let's show how to stack these sounds. Let's go to the factory presets, piano. And if you're ever lost on sound selection, just go to the grand piano. Can you see me? Let me make sure the screen works. Oh, okay, the screen works. We're good. Yeah, let's do the NBA. So I got the, so this is gonna take a little bit more effort. Yeah, I'm not using that nuked reverb anymore. Let me just kind of get in the flow of just playing around with the piano. Now, something that helps me sometimes is just adding delay and listening to the delay and then turning up. I thought you said Vanessa Williams. Turning up the reverb. And the mod wheel on the reverb so it changes the pitch. I want to go. What did I do? Post more rock tutorials. Let's record that. With piano, I just like to record a little riff. Got it, my fingers ready. And I'll show you how to flip this into a melody. So even if you're not good at piano playing, hold on, I just knocked everything off my desk. So with rock, you need real instruments. And that's why people don't do too many rock things in FLs, because you're recording a guitar into it. It's kind of, maybe I'll record guitar today if we have enough time, into this track. I'm 15 and I want to make music. I have every VST like Omnisphere Contact, but I just can't make a viral catchy beat. Well, I mean, you're in the right place to learn. Can you post, okay, are you giving out a copy of one? It's not gonna be 18 winners. We don't have that big of a budget. We're giving away to one winner. Let me be clear, one winner. We're giving away Nexus 3. You can enter for free at busyworksbeats.com/giveaway. All right, so now that you have your riff, you kind of got the velocities. That's all you really need, is that humanized velocity. I'm just gonna hit Alt, drag these notes over. I haven't used melodics. I've heard about it, but I haven't used it. And let's add these step notes in here. And hit Shift and just drag them over. And here's the trick. Once you have this, all you have to do now is just transpose this. So listen to your head. Your head's telling you the notes it wants to hear. Boom, 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 boom. And now I'll hit Shift, left click, and drag your whole chord progression so that your top note is now A sharp or B flat. Okay, so that's a quick little fake way to play piano. Sometimes you can't play that long in a row. And then here, all you want to do is just change up your step note so that it leads back up to D sharp. So right here, we left, you have to use reverse math. I'm talking a little bit complicated, but the notes were 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. They're four notes away. So now I have to make sure that C sharp is four notes away from D sharp. And this is a little convoluted because we have to think in reverse. So D sharp, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's make this top note B. So I'm just transposing it. So B is the top note. And just fit this in the key. In this case, it's going to be B flat, not B. And then it loops back around perfectly. Now it's kind of janky, so let's hit Alt Q to get the timing right. And now it sounds like I know how to play piano when I really just kind of hacked our way through it. Now when you're looking at it, we're going to look at it as a longer piece. So we started at D sharp, went down to A sharp or B flat. I'm just saying sharp so it's easier. What's up, Dilio T2K? I mean, it's a breath of fresh air. It makes me want to use the old sounds in a new way, if that makes sense, because they give you a little bit more control over the sound. I think it's just going to make people more excited about Nexus in general. I mean, I haven't found the new sounds in it yet. I don't even know how to differentiate between the new sounds, but it's easier to search, which is worth it, I guess. But I don't know, to each his own, whatever inspires you. And let's make this creepy. So let's hit Shift and just pull this up one. B's not in our key, remember? I mean, it's the same sound, nothing. It's all imported sounds from the other one. Seems like it sounds a little bit cleaner, but that could be just perception. Yeah, Cybertruck. So see how that key change sounded cool? And then we'll pull this up one so that fits the key. I don't know, I'm just kind of winging the scale here. There's no set scale, I was just playing all the black notes. What scale do I play in usually? Minor scales. I don't really use major too many times. Oh, you did a video? We just have to change a couple notes. But see how it sounds like we're actually playing piano, though? Off of that one little idea we had. And now you can kind of hack your way through it. But it's a mindset. Then it goes back. So what I would do here is maybe not hit the chords again, like boom, boom. Let me see. I'm just going to pull down the velocity on these hard notes. Just process of elimination, really, but you have to know why you're doing stuff. Okay, so let's speed it up. So here's what I've noticed when you're making beats. It seems like you guys are slowing down your BPM because you can hear your drums better or something, but you want to speed up your BPMs because for the most part, the beats that don't sound good sound really, really slow, and that's because your BPMs are really low. So let's speed this up. And let's start working with the reverb now, because now that we have the sound, let me save this before we forget to save. Yeah, Control S has to be like a hardwired command in your brain. Okay, so let's go to the bass. Let's keep this extremely simple and streamlined. I don't want to get too like experimental today. All you want to do for your bass is copy all your chord progression and paste it into your bass. Now you're like, paste chords into bass. So what we want to do now is go to Factory Library Presets, go to Bass, and let's see how far we can push this. So we want a triangle wave. Let's go to Basic Triangle. And we want the notes to overlap a little bit. So what we have to do is activate the, what's it called, legato mode. So let's go to legato mode. And then we want the speed of the portamento to be a little bit slower so the notes bend different. You can hear them bend a little bit slower. I don't want to get too deep into sound design, but that's that. Let's take off the reverb. And now that you have the chord progression in your bass, what you can do now is just decide what notes you want to play. So in this case, I want to play the root note. Let's add this to the playlist. And you could take out the notes you don't want to play. I would, though, advise that you switch it up so it's not just root notes the whole time. Like, for example, on the second chord, I want the bass to change. I'll probably go to the note A sharp or B flat. And it just makes the bass feel like it's moving. I like that C, sounded cool. But here I want to change it up, so just kind of, what are the notes? Let's hit Control-Alt-Z to go back. So I wanted to go from C sharp to G sharp, and then maybe back to the tonic. We'll see what it sounds like. Yeah, I would not buy the bundle for anything right away. I would always, that's just the way I do though. I didn't buy the FL everything bundle. I didn't buy the Nexus everything bundle. You know, if I'm gonna go everything on something, I would probably buy a keyboard with the same amount of money because it gets me a different quality of sound. Some kids are. And it looks like I forgot that last bar. Didn't even realize that. So here's what we're gonna do. Hit Alt Q and just hit Control A, hit Alt, left click, make sure the notes overlap just a little bit. Now let's hit Control down so that these notes are in the bass octave. And I'll show you how to beef up the bass in a little bit. FL Studio Tron. Looks like, you know what I just realized? I didn't write out the eighth bar. I didn't realize that. Okay, that makes sense as to why that was missing. Now here's how you make your piano sound different. Clone it, make it unique, and all you have to do here is hit Control Up to pull it up an octave. So now you have your piano sounding like it's super complex. I'm gonna make this more unique. So if you want to make this piano sound a little more realistic, I'm gonna flex a little bit, virtually speaking, and write in scale runs going downward in triplets. So when piano players use scale runs, most of the time they're using three notes at a time. So I was like, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. I don't know how to do it because my fingers aren't trained to do it, but it's a certain way they move their, they position off their thumb, I think. And it's in threes. So all you have to do is, let's do this first. Okay, so I sliced it here right at that last, what is this? The last beat, half beat. Excuse me. And we need to map out all the notes in our scale that we're using. Let's just use the notes that we're using in this chord progression. Okay, so we're gonna type in the notes one by one all the way down. And we use C sharp. A, G, F, F, D sharp, C sharp, B, and A. So all these notes right here, we're going to use this as a template. So I'm going to slide this to the right just so it doesn't get too crazy. Chambers, what up, Young Chambers? And he doesn't go by Young Chambers anymore. He's like, don't call me Young Chambers. I'm trying to decide, do we need this chord for it to sound like it's chord progression? Hold on. So what I might do is start the downward thing right here. Let's just try it. Now, luckily, it's just we didn't change too much. So if I ever mess up, I'm just going to go back and copy it. I don't know what scale it is. I have no idea. I would have to map it out. So I see a whole. I look at the half tones and the whole tones. So from what I see a half, whole. So that could be whole, half, whole, half, whole. It looks like a variation of a minor scale. But I don't know. Whatever. Is it? I don't know. I was playing notes. It probably was the major because technically I started off on the pentatonic, major pentatonic, so you're right. Oh, for real? Okay. So let me see if we can do this. Let me see if there's a shortcut in FL. If we can arpeggiate going down like in triplets. I don't know if that's a thing. Let's hit Alt A to create the arpeggio. Let's do, now see it knocks us out for a couple things. I don't use this function that way. So let me not make it complicated. What we're gonna do though, let's go to snap to grid, triplet mode, 1/3 beat, and just take each note, move it over one. This is probably gonna play way too fast, but I can fix it once we get it done. And just slide the notes over and make them short. Or just slide them over. You really don't have to worry about the length. I'll show you a trick. Just make sure that start time is in the right spot. And this will make it sound like we're actually skilled at scale runs. So highlight these notes, hit Alt L, and then go to only with selection, and it will shorten the notes out and just make the last note, the long note, just shorten that out manually. Now this should sound cool. If it doesn't sound cool, I'll stretch it. See how it makes it sound like official. Now when you do this, you have to make it sound real though. So you're not gonna be hitting every key at the same velocity. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. So it goes loud, middle, quiet, loud, middle, quiet, loud, middle, quiet. And you can kind of go down and make it more realistic. Jimenez is back. Just a little trick you can try. Let's hear it in context. If you want to make it sound even crazier, assuming that you have what's called a sustain pedal held or damper pedal, you would drag the notes out a little bit. Pull the this bass down one more octave. Alright, so let's work on this bass a little bit. I'm just gonna change the modulation. Where are we at? Let's go to 1/32nd. So that the bass snaps a little bit faster when they change notes. Let's go to their effects. Let's go to insert and let's insert a distortion because we need upper harmonics for our bass. Not too much though. That's why I use a triangle wave. What's up, Layton? Aren't the notes and the scale the same as the key? The key and scale are the same thing. I don't know if what your question's asking, but... Here's something else I want to add in here. I want to add a chorus. So let's add another insert and let's put it on chorus mode. This should widen out the bass. Now, some chorus plugins don't act like other chorus plugins. So it's kind of like hit or miss, really. This one's okay. I mean, I think the octave's too low. I think that's the problem. See how the sound's kind of like iffy. Lower this an octave. Let's add a filter to it. Area 51 type beat. Kind of close, but it needs a little more edge. I just don't want to waste time trying to sound design here. Look at that sound though, we have to really kind of know how to do it. It's close, but it's not exactly where I'm trying to go with it. So I may change up the melodic kind of structure. So it's not just like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, the chorus kind of, I don't like the way it is. I was trying to give you that Drake style, but it just didn't come out the way I expected. So let's turn that up. And let's turn off the distortion in that case. We really don't need it. Leave it as is. You're right. We're trying to figure out if it's worth the money right now. Let's add some drums. So again, we're going for the NBA Youngboy. So he uses modern trap drums. So let's go to busyworksbeats.com. I have some Ultimate Producer drums in here. One thing about this is, though, you don't want the kick competing with the bass. So let's turn the bass down. Also, let's try adding some effects like we had before. We had, what, backmask, was it? Backmask. I can't spell. Pull back the mix level. So let's give it that modern trap touch, just to be fair. Now, again, for me... I don't like the effect going all the way through. So let's create a 50% mark and just have it automate to kind of go up every now and again. So it's not repeating the same thing over and over and over and over again. You can kind of hear it go. Did I count this right? 1, 2, 1. Oh, you know what? I didn't count this. I forgot to add a little gap. My bad. Let's do this. Backmask, yeah. I rarely use it, but in this case, it works. Shout out to everybody. Question in the round here. Question into the round here. Did someone use an app? Oh, no. I never use any app to learn keys. The stream, I mean, we'll go probably 2 hours max. It's not going to be super, super long. How does it feel knowing that most producers that will be big this coming decade will have learned from you? That's going to be amazing. I can't wait to see your success. We already have producers on the top charts and everything right now. That's a great thing. I mean, that's kind of the point, is get to make everybody successful. All right, so let's grab some snares from here. Actually, I think I have some snares in Beat Magic. These are more snaps. Forgot I had snaps in here. And claps. Probably for a different genre. Boom, boom, boom. Let me get into the drum selection real quick. Oh, clap is too dark. I hear what you're Trizza, Flock of Flame. I want to play you on Call of Duty. If I could find some time. This whole weekend, what did they call it? Black Cyber Weekend or whatever? Black Cyber Weekend got me out here looking like a field slate. No, I'm just playing. It's fun, but it takes a lot of work. And I had to redo like my whole website at the same time. Shout out to all the Black Friday sales. Actually, let's use some Trizza drums since we're here. Duh. Let's use the Ultimate Kit. I like using my friend's sounds, period. That's the only sounds I use. I have a whole folder with my friend's sounds in here. Let's use Trizza Flock of Flame sounds, the producer kit. Still looking to collab with you on a kit, Trizza, if you're still interested. Because sound design takes a long time. Maybe later if you're... I may got a family though. I don't have all that to attend to, but after all this Black Cyber Weekend or whatever it's called, I am usually free at the nighttime. So we got the Ultimate Kit open. Let's grab some kicks. I like the kick called Knock. So you got to think, these guys are trying to tell street stories, so you don't want to make the drums too distracting. Oh yeah, I'm definitely... Call of Duty is so fun. Oh my gosh. It's a really well done game. Like, I don't think I'll get bored of it for probably a year or two. And I could be overreaching, but it doesn't feel like you can get bored of it. Who else is Call of Duty in here? And also might give the bass a little more movement. So let me turn off the bass right now. But again, the goal is not to get in the way of the piano. So now once you have the canvas done, now you go back and you add the little touches, like timing touches. So for example, the melody is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. I mean, who plays that way? PUBG is still a thing. Once Modern Warfare came out, I kind of stopped playing PUBG. It's just like, I don't even play GTA Online anymore. It's like Call of Duty is my only game I play online, and this other strategy game I like. Eating chips type beat. No, I never heard that one before. Berserk. Nope, I missed that deal. I don't really like Waves. They have good plugins, but I don't like their like business people. I like the plugins, unfortunately, but I don't like the way they do business. Oh, there we go. That's smart. Call of Duty. So let me kind of give the kicks a little more life. Up CTH. If you really want to take it hard, you're gonna you want to reverse the whole piano. Let's see if we can do that. That'd be a cool idea. So here's what we'll do. We will record the... I have to do it this way for live stream sake. You can just... For you guys at home, you can just right click. You can go to consolidate this track and you can do from track start. I can't do that while I'm live because it restarts my whole situation. So let's go to Edison. Let's go to on play, record, hit stop, hit play. Yeah, reversing the piano might be cool, but usually on NBA Youngboy's stuff, I don't think he does a reverse piano. What's up, Mr. Chico? Six. It is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I was trying to explain music theory. All right, so let's send it to the playlist. And I'm gonna reverse it. Do the bass with your mouth. It kind of needs an 808, but I'm kind of showing Nexus plugins. So again, certain restrictions. Let's hit reverse. Here's what reverse piano sounds like. It's, I guess, too much movement on the in-betweens. Here's what I would do for the reversed. I would just play straight chords. So to be fair, I'll do it that way. Singing R&B. There we go. Just too much movement for reverse. Also, it looks like this is off timing, too. Just to be fair, let's move it back. There we go. I didn't even see that. Either way, it's too much jumping going on. So you got to realize this is why this all connects. Your melody ties into your chords, ties into your drums. So we're really listening to the musical rhythm before we listen to the drum rhythm. So when they mismatch, that's when you have problems. So right here, I would have to go in and change the chords to match your drums. The timing of your chords. So watch. And just bring certain chords in earlier. I forgot I had this on triplets. No wonder. Now we have a little bit of overlap that kind of throws off the arpeggio function. So to handle that, you highlight the notes, hit Alt L. Now the issue is you have to redrag out the notes. This is why FL gets a little tedious. I don't know why they cut off notes in FL. I'm not sure whose decision that was. But for whatever reason, if notes overlap, they cut each other off. And it makes you forcibly go in and do all these small little changes that are pretty tedious when you make changes. But that's the life of a DAW. Also, I'm going to change this. So now the piano is starting to match with the drums a little bit more. It's one of those things where when you create a whole system, you change one thing, it changes 20 other things. Same thing with your beat. So that's why when you start off with your metronome, tempo, go next to your chords, move to your melody, go to your bass line, then create your drums, because that's going to be dictated by everything before it. But I should have considered that while creating the chords, because now we have to go back and edit the chords. Also, let's try a different key. Let's hit shift down. Yeah, I'm trying to get these chords. The timing has to be right. So I don't want to jump too far ahead. There's a 9-step process for making songs. You start with the metronome, get the tempo, you move to the chords. When did I make Wavy Guitars? I made that with Justin Fava. Wait, who made Wavy Guitars? I think it was Justin Fava. That was a long time ago, probably a year ago by now. But anyway, but the issue with some of those packs that I didn't like was just that there was a royalty split. I was trying to get it royalty free for you guys, but some producers, they forced the royalty thing, and I know it takes away the luster of the sounds sometimes. Especially if you don't know the producer who made it, you're just like, what? Yeah, your NBA Youngboy talks about the streets. What was I talking about, though? I lost my train of thought. Oh, the 9-set process. So you start with the metronome or the tempo, move to your chords. From your chords, you get your melody. From your chords derives also the bass after your melody. From your bass, you add the drums. After the drums, you add your vocals. After vocals, you do the mixing. After the mixing, you do the mastering, and then you do the marketing. There's a 9-step process for making any song. And the reason you follow that process is so you don't have to do like I did and go back and fix all this stuff. Good looks, Lace Bacon. Filling in the gaps right now. Now the timing here got a little weird. Okay, so I have to make sure these notes make sense. Now, can a piano player play this? I don't know, but it sounds decent enough. Let me get the piano straight and then I'll get to the drum solo. Okay, so now we have that. Let's copy and paste this into pattern 3. We're gonna miss the little this thing. I don't think we need it anyway. Hit Control up. Could you type it? Well, it's in our premium section. Technically, I was just giving you like a preview. Let's make a 200 BPM beat. Let's go. I was trying to show off Nexus. So this is a Nexus bass. I think we need technically an 808 for this beat. Oh, you know, our bass changed. Duh. So let me do it this way. Boom, boom. So the way I do my bass is in a higher octave so I can actually hear what the bass is doing. I gotta practice a little bit. Hold up. So here's where the rhythm comes in. Typed the wrong notes, but whatever. Oh, tell me they recorded. Hit Alt Q. So when I... These have to be defined note lengths. To do this, you can hit Control A, hit Edit, and go down to Discard Note Lengths, and it will make everything the same length. And now you can just shorten it with Alt Left. Hit Control Down. Now I'm going to add my drums. So I'm following my own process. Chords, melody, bass, then the drums. If I did the drums before the bass, I would have to go back and change the bass timing. Do some producer kit drums. It Again, this beat really calls for an 808, but whatever. Simon Sarita came out with the new Capital. What was it called? Capital Drum Kit. So you hear the kick and the bass conflict. Here's what I'll do. Let's delay the bass just a little bit, just for this video's sake. Probably wouldn't do this production-wise. Hear that clipping? Now we got to do gain staging. There's a lot going on here. The arpeggio. Let's see what the arpeggio will add. Let's do arpeggio. Let's go up. Adds more movement, but let's see, we probably have to mess. Almost too much movement. Let's slow it down a little bit. It'd be cool if we could kind of blend in an arpeggio. That'd be a cool function, like a mixed level for the arp. I think the arp kind of takes away from the melody timing, though, in my opinion. Yeah, this is the grand piano from Nexus. My fault. I didn't see your comment. Cool sound, but all right, let's run this through some effects. So let's do halftime. Let me swap out the kick. So now the goal is just make the beat sound faster without using hi-hats. So this is a technique you just want to get used to doing while you're making beats. If you could figure out how to make your beat sound faster with the BPM, with the rhythm, of the kicks or your 808s, or just the general music, do that before you add the hi-hats, in my opinion. Bay areas. Here's what I'll do. I'm going to group. I don't know if we can group two of these. Can we? Oh yeah. Wow. So I just grouped two different patterns into one. This way we can transpose everything all at once instead of going throughout the keys. So right click, transpose this. Let's pull it up 5 semitones. Still trying to figure out if Nexus 3 is worth it. How many people are in here? So we need a consensus. What do you guys think so far? We have about a nice sample size, about 200 folks in here. Do you think Nexus is good or bad? Like, do you think it's better? Actually, let's put it this way. Do you think it's fire or Snowflake so far? I mean, it's the same stock sounds. I don't think it's, I don't know. Finish up this track a little bit. I'm trying to focus on the actual sound because the drums aren't a part of Nexus. So, I mean, if I make the drum sound cool, it doesn't really show us how good Nexus is. I think it's 200 to start. I already had it, Nexus 2, so it was 99 bucks. gotta handle these levels. These levels are too lopsided right now. Let's fix this. I wish FL just came out with a simple imager plugin. That would just make everything so much easier. But let's use the Isotope Ozone. I guess the chat could help speed you up to date, whatever it's called, get you up to date. Widening out the bass a little bit so it doesn't conflict with the kick so much. It's kind of the same. I mean, and this is the grand piano out of all the sounds. Let's go back and at least change the sounds. But this is the stock stuff. I'm just trying to show you what your stuff's going to sound like, because I already have all the expansions I want. One note I want to take out is like a double note. It might be halftime. Let me see. Couple notes in here that are too rapid. I don't want to spend a decade changing every single note. Let's see which piano fits though. Let's go from the top. Sometimes if you hit the soft clipper too hard, it makes this nasty distortion sound. I'm trying to avoid that. I paid $100 for Sample Tank 3 a while ago. It came with double the sounds. Of course, most of that was orchestral sounds. Yeah, it depends on what you're going for. I don't know. I didn't buy all their expansions to tell you. The expansions I have are these listed on the left. My favorite ones are the house. I forget which one though. Deep house, I like that one. I haven't used it in a long time though. Tropical house is cool. And what else is cool in here? Some of the Hollywood sounds are cool. I just search stuff and I find stuff. I don't know which Hollywood thing it's in. So the Hollywood are cool. Tropical house is cool. The deep house is cool. I don't use the rest. I mean, unless I search the sounds and they just pull up. I don't really go to them. And I don't buy expansions, so I don't know. Type of beat, NBA Youngboy-esque, just piano based. 50k? No, it's not. It's 2k max. It's 200 to start. Oh, I remember it. That's a weird. You gotta reword your question. I don't know what you mean by when releasing songs. Would you recommend it to producers? I'm trying to figure it out now. I mean, I'm using the same sounds I used before, so it's like, is it worth the upgrade? I'm not sure. Not too many people have Logic, unfortunately, who watch me, so I mean, we just don't get that many Logic requests. It's a pretty cool piano sound. Needs like a heavy distorted 808. I like this kind of washed piano sound. Let's see what else they got. What's up? D-Boy. Let me add a little bit of trapanese to it. Give it a little more of a trap sound. Again, trap's not really a sound, it's the stuff you do to the sound. Like just adding this makes it way more trappy. Now it sounds cool just because it has that effect on it. This is Nexus 3. No, this is the basic version. I just have... What happens when you buy Nexus 3? It's backward compatible, so you can import all the old sound packs that you had. So that's all I did. These are old sound packs I already had. All these patches sound way better with this little pitch bend thing. Backmask, I don't use it that much. I mean, other people might be able to recommend it. I just don't use it that much to really recommend it like that. Let me take off backmask. Joe Budden Podcast Fan Bufo. Wait, what was your question, Mobile? My bad. Trapifying beats? What? Oh, you don't know. Let's swap out the sounds. Let's go to other sounds. I mean, piano's gonna be piano. Nothing's really gonna change. Let's do harps. You want marketing tips right now? Go watch the video about ClickFunnels and my YouTube secrets video. We go over a lot of marketing stuff. They don't have a lot of stock bell sounds. I'm actually surprised. So we went over these earlier. If you rewind, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 bell sounds. Like modern trap kind of requires bell. So I'm confused as to why there's only 11 bell sounds. But again, this is the factory library. And these are sounds they came up with years and years ago. They may have updated the sound library for the factory, but I don't know which new sounds they've added because they just put it all in one. And you can't tell the difference. So it seems like they didn't really update the core library so much. Maybe the expansions they did, but not the core library. Which is fine. I mean, it's not a hindrance. Try some guitars, see what they sound like. It's risky. I mean, if you already have Nexus, you can upgrade for a lot cheaper. I just like the search function. It seems like they are doing a lot to kind of move forward, if that makes sense. Yeah, I'm not buying you the $2,000 Nexus. That's ridiculous. I'm giving away the $200 one. Here, I forgot to mention, you guys can enter for free to win Nexus 3 at busyworkbeats.com/giveaway. So be sure to enter. It's free to enter. Let's add a little more flair to this melody. Let's just do like a melody loop. Let's act as if we're you and we're creating melody loops for our friends. I'm going to add one more plug-in here to make the sound cooler. Cooper Time Cube. Where are you at? Cooper. Let's do the Haas effect. So I'm running this through a lot of plugins. If you just joined, I'm running it through a vibrato effect. I'm running it through a reverse effect, halftime, and a widening effect. Let's pull this up an octave. Wait, let me see. I don't know if I did this inside the plugin or not. Where are we at? System. But again, without the effects, here's what it sounds like. It doesn't sound that cool without the effects. Sounds cool. I said trap is really an effect process. You really just can just change it to any sound. It's all going to sound the same at the end. And I think, I mean, we showed Nexus for what it was. I'll say from what I see so far, it's just the same stock sounds as before, which is the reality. They are literally the same sounds. They may have added new sounds, but they don't tell you which sounds are new, so it's kind of pointless saying there's new sounds when you don't know which sounds are new. And then on top, again, this sounds like a heavy criticism. I like it. Like, I like the money I spend on it, but that's because I have $100 to put on the upgrade for Nexus 3, and I already had Nexus 2. But the benefits of Nexus in general are that they have highly focused sounds. So they have tropical house sounds. Like, let's open up a tropical house marimba, for example. Where's the marimba? I think they have its own, or flute. And they could run that through all these effects. Yeah, it's basically a new search function. They give you deeper stuff in the features, but the sounds are basically the same. Run this through. What's marimba? I always forget. Oh, marimba. So here's just a marimba run through all these effects. So they have highly focused sounds. That's what I like about Nexus. Is just like, I don't have to go to Omnisphere and search a thousand and thousand sounds to figure out the exact one I want. Nexus just gives me like, hey, here's this kit. Here's this one, and it's just, it's a good restriction to me, for my opinion. That's Nexus in general, but for Nexus 3, what you get new is all this stuff here, basically. You get all, this is what's new about Nexus, this area right here, this whole little strip thing. A search, you get a better arpeggio function, transgate, and cooler effects, maybe. That's really it. It's just like a functionality upgrade, more than a sound upgrade. Now, I'm sure they have cool sounds they release, but I haven't bought their sound packs in, like, you know, I don't know which one was my last one. Let's go to Hollywood expansion, for example, and click on some kind of string. I don't know. I have Falcon, but Falcon turns me off because the sounds are kind of whack. When you open up the stock sounds, the sounds are just, like, not attractive. I know Falcon can do a lot, but the stock factory sounds on that Falcon are just not impressive to me. And again, that's my opinion. And it's very convoluted on how to use Falcon. I'm sure it can do a lot, but I haven't really liked it. I bought it and I don't really like it. I thought I would like it way better. Let me do a couple things here. And again, don't forget to, Christmas 2015. Don't forget to enter the free giveaway. We're giving away Nexus 3 at busyworksbeats.com/giveaway. I was going to pull the bass in mono and widen out the top. There we go. So again, these are not the default. Let me take off these effects because I'm giving you a twisted perception of the sound. So here's what it sounds like raw. are not factory libraries, by the way. Favorite UA plugins, the SSL channel strip, the distressor. What else from UA? I like the Culture Vulture a lot for 808s and bass. Cooper Time Cube's cool. And then the stuff that comes with like your interface, those are cool too. Like this, they give you a lot of plugins. But this is an expansion. That's why I'm trying to use the factory stuff so you guys get an idea of like what it actually sounds like. Because chances are you're not going to buy everything all at once. So let's go to the factory stuff. It's already out. Nexus 3 is already out. I'm just going through presets at this point, just to show you what it sounds like. Let's go to vocals. It might not stack well with vocals, so let's see. And this is without any effects. Let's hear what it sounds like with effects. My BST doesn't have a set date right now. I'm working on behind the scenes stuff for it. Trying to bring you the sounds you actually want, not just like random thrown together sounds. Sound design takes a lot more time than people think. Oh, let's definitely skip the trance gates. We're not gonna get those. Okay, here's my general kind of new rounded opinion about Nexus. It's built for electronic genres. I wouldn't say EDM, but just electronic genres. And I mean, yes, there's expansions for a trap or hip hop or whatever, but the way they design sounds is focused on a certain type of genre. Like the fact that there weren't that many bells kind of is alarming in a trap based. But these are the same sounds as before, though. Just want to make that very clear. But it may be my perception, but the sounds do feel a little bit cleaner. I think Dilio asked me this earlier. They do feel a little bit cleaner. I don't know if they did anything to the sound. It just could be me guessing, but... Yeah, it just shows that their sound designers aren't really tapped into like what we actually want. Like for example, if you load up my plugin called Vintage Fire, which you can get actually $70 off Vintage Fire using code 70. Let me use code 70. I just want to let you know about that deal. It's still active. For example, our bell sounds, we have how many? Just in this plugin alone, we have like 30. I'm just guessing, just going off of a visual. So we have the bells start from here all the way to here. That's how important bells are in trap. And I hand design all these sounds and they have a vibe to them. So let me turn these up. Let me run my sounds. So let's run the same exact chord progression through my sounds just to show you that there is a huge difference here. Pull this down one octave. Our sounds are analog, so they feel alive. Some of these notes are too high. Okay, so it just has that depth, whereas their sounds are cool, but it's just not the same. That's all. So we're giving our plug-in stuff a bit of an upgrade just so people can really get into it. So you can find Vintage Fire here. I'll leave a link. And this is only $20 if you use that code that I just gave you, which is code 70. The wrong note somewhere doing something. I think I clicked the wrong note. So let me, where's the long chord progression at? Let's copy this. I copied the wrong chord progression too. Paste it into Vintage Fire. I just want to show Vintage Fire and just to compare the sound. Let's compare their Nexus sound versus Vintage Fire just to see. And let's do it like this. Let's do one bar of theirs, one bar of mine. So theirs will be first, mine will be second. Theirs will be in pink or red or whatever. Mine will be second. So let's go to their bells, just to be fair. Let's go to factory library, type in bell. Just to show you how their sounds are not like what we need them to be as far as default sounds. I'll even pick the best bell that I think. Okay, I picked their poppy bell. And without reverb and delay. Down one octave. So that's the best bell from their library, I think. Let's go to Vintage Fire. Let me pull up a bell that I like. Run these side by side. Let's pull this down. Find a bell that I think fits his vibe. There are more, but I mean, they're not. There are synth bells here. For example, you can go to factory libraries, go to all, and you could type in bell. But I mean, I'm not really looking for a synthy style bell. So to be fair, yeah, you're right. There are a couple more bells. Poppy bells. This is probably the best one though. Let me go back to theirs. What pattern was theirs on? The VZ bell sounds cool too. I'll give it that. Now let me pick a bell from my plugin. Where's my pattern? I'm trying to find a bell that compares so they're similar. I haven't made stuff for trap. This one's super creepy, the Halloween bell. It's already pitched for you, so it's super already like Travis Scotty, basically. One of my favorite patches to create. I'm trying to find a bell that has the same harmonics. Give me a second. Similar in a way, I guess. Okay, so I'll play theirs and then play ours. Keep in mind, theirs has a bunch of reverb and stuff on it, so let's take that off. Harmonics are different, but you could definitely feel the sound in the center of your head. This is closer, I guess. Now this is a really detuned bell from Vintage Fire. This is almost too detuned. That's not easy to compare. up. I'll end it on our Vintage Fire versus Nexus bells. I just have so many more bells under my plugin. But again, you can enter for free for Nexus 3. Sorcerer's Stone made after Harry Potter. It's very detuned as well. Kind of similar here. Bells are so far in range, and wait till you see the new plugin. Anyway, I was trying to find a bell that kind of matched their bell, but our bells are a little more custom made. Anyway, I made the plugin for trap, lo-fi, hip-hop, R&B. You can get it for $20 for this holiday season only. That's why I'm showing it to you right now, and that's at busyworksbeats.com/vintagefire. It loads up on PC, Mac, all the major DAWs. We have a new plugin software coming soon. I'm doing a lot of stuff behind the scenes to bring it to you. And that's just a lot of stuff going on. So anyway, you can get it for $20. Loads up in any DAW. Very easy to install. You just hit yes, 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 yes. And that's pretty much it. So my conclusion about Nexus 3, if you never bought Nexus, it might be a cool place to start. If you already have Nexus, it's not that much of an upgrade. I mean, there is a lot of stuff going on. I don't want to belittle the developers' time and effort that went into this. I'm not saying that they didn't do anything. I'm saying that what I would upgrade for was potentially maybe more sounds or more something. But the upgrade is about like microscopic features that I never really used anyway, like the arpeggiator layering. What else? The effects, visuals. I didn't really care so much about that with Nexus 2. So the upgrade isn't that dramatic of a difference. But if you're getting Nexus for the first time, this will be a cool place to start, because I think they're using this as a nice platform to bring in, you know, their future stuff that they have for the plugin. So that's my opinion, my overall opinion about Nexus 3. It just makes me kind of want to get into Nexus a little bit more, just have a little more fun with it. But can't wait for our new thing to come out. It's a lot of stuff coming. Yeah, free updates. So your updates, depending on when you bought it, you probably already have all the updates right now. So you should, if your list isn't this big, then you need to check your email for the update email that we sent out. So it should be 3 columns of sounds in here. Here's one of the updated sounds. Let me turn off these volume things because they're making it clip. All right, so shout out to the live stream. Again, you can enter for free. Don't forget to enter for free, because I don't want to hear a week later that, oh, you didn't tell me. It's like, no, I told you 8 times on the live stream. Go to a cool sound. When did Vintage Fire patch come out? You just want to check either your spam or your promotions tab. I'll resend it today just because a lot of people are like, where are my updates? If your sounds don't look like this, then you need update. So I'll send it back out, but check your emails. We email it out every time we do an update. If we do an update, we haven't done an update in a while, but it's because I'm working on something even bigger. Nexus 3 dropped Black Friday. Alright. So I'll just give people time to enter that giveaway for free. Just don't forget. We're pretty much done this stream. How long have we been on this? An hour and a half? Yeah. You can tell my voice is going. Boom, 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 boom. Thank you. playing major chords at this point. All right, so at this point, I'm wasting time. I have a lot to do today. It was fun talking about Nexus 3. I gave my opinion again, just as a recap. You can enter the giveaway for free at busyworksbeats.com/giveaway. We're giving away Nexus 3 this Friday. My opinion is Nexus 3 for those who already have Nexus 2. In my opinion, the only update is just a feature update. I wouldn't update if you're not super excited about Nexus 3. If you've never had Nexus at all, this is a great place to start. And that's my opinion. Okay, it's very simple at the end of the day. Shout out to Illinois and everybody else. Hood Known. Leah's in here. Mrs. Wright, what's up? Enter what? It's a Nexus 3 giveaway. So I have a lot to do. It's just thinking about it just drains me already. But anyway, enjoy your week. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.